Hello everyone, Leo here, let's talk dev. Today's video is about screenshot testing using Cypress. This video is based on a blog post I wrote a few weeks ago, and I decided to make a video version of it. You will learn why we want screenshot testing and how to use Cypress for it. Let's get started. Jumping into the why, the inspiration for this video and blog post came from my work. There, we have a design system and we want to prevent mistakes. Imagine, for example, someone changes a padding property somewhere and this change affects wrong components. The developer may have checked a few examples while they're coding, but this screenshot testing will compare pixel by pixel all the examples of your documentation website. Talking about documentation, here is a sample website for this video. This website shows how to use the badge and button components. They will be tested by Cypress up next. Here's the documentation website project in the terminal. As you can see, we are using the serve package to host the content of the public folder. In a different terminal, let's install Cypress and Cypress image snapshot. In this video, we are using the Cypress image snapshot package. However, there are other plugins similar to this one listed in the Cypress website. VS Code time. Once we have the package installed, we will set up Cypress to use Cypress image snapshot. The first step is creating a JavaScript file which will add Cypress image snapshot as a plugin. The second step is adding the Cypress image snapshot command. This code can be found in the README from their project. Nothing special here. The third step is related to the Cypress headings, and if you ever have used Cypress before, you may recognize them. You can see here, we are setting the base URL to localhost, which is the server running our sample website. And we are also disabling the video recording to speed up our tests. Next, it is time to create the screenshot test. Here's the good stuff. In the first line, we are setting up the page that will be tested. Then, the test cases are dynamically created based in the array of routes. The test is very straightforward. For each route, Cypress will look for an element called Cypress wrapper and then check if the image matches the previous screenshot. The last step is replacing the test script to Cypress. We're good to go back to the terminal. Time to run Cypress for the first time. Cypress offers two different ways to run tests. One is headless in the terminal, and another one is using their UI. Let's start by the headless version, running npm test run. The output of this run shows that all tests pass, and you can also see here the image paths. The images are looking good. If you want to watch the test running, you may want to use the open option. This will open Cypress UI, and there you can read all Cypress settings. You can even change the browser running the test. Let's run our test. Oops, what's going on? The test failed, but this error is related to the image dimensions. It happens when we switch executions from headless to no headless mode. Let's go back to the terminal and pass an environment variable to update all snapshots. Careful here, only update snapshots when you really need. Let's go back to VS Code and change our button documentation. We will change the label of the button, which will break the tests. Keep in mind that if we change the CSS classes, Cypress would also fail. Running tests. Oops! Cypress failed because the element doesn't match the previous screenshot. If you go to the project folder, you'll see a folder containing the screenshots, and then you can compare and see what is wrong. From here, you can update the snapshots if you intentionally understand the current component is correct, or you can go back to your code and revert your changes. That's all for today, folks. Are you considering screenshot testing in your project? Let me know in the comments. See you around. Bye!